The U.S. Navy fleet is the largest in the world. It's the best in the world, both in terms of quality and quantity. The 7th Fleet, based out of Japan, plays a very important role as it's forward deployed and oversees a vast area. Reports now indicate that from mid-2018, ANSLQ-59, which is also known as SEWIP, Surface Electronic Warfare Improvement Program, Block 3T is supporting the 7th Fleet Urgent Operational Need, UON. In this video, Defense Updates analyzes the installation of new SEWIP Block 3T ANSLQ-59 electronic warfare system to U.S. Navy 7th Fleet. Let's get started. This video is sponsored by War Thunder. If you are, like us, fascinated by military vehicles and technology, I recommend you give War Thunder a try. It's a military vehicle combat game, which you can download and play for free on PC, PlayStation 4, and Xbox One, with cross-platform support. It has a huge variety of more than 1,200 playable aircraft, tanks, helicopters, and ships from the 1930s to the 1990s, which you can take to battle on land, in the air, and at sea on more than 80 theaters of war. War Thunder's been kind enough to offer all Defense Updates viewers a special bonus, which will grant you a free premium tank, aircraft, or ship, and 3 days of premium account time for registering using our link in the description below. So take the plunge and join more than 20 million players from around the world. China claims most of the South China Sea. It's said that it has indisputable sovereignty over the area. Vietnam, Philippines, Malaysia, Brunei, and Taiwan have disputed these claims. The route is significant, as about $5 trillion in trade through shipping passes each year. Countries like the US, Japan, and India have no claims in the area and want freedom of navigation as per international maritime laws. China has tried imposing a unilateral decision as per which all ships and aircraft navigating in the area need to identify itself to the Chinese Navy. U.S. military regularly sends warships and aircraft in the region to establish freedom of navigation, and this is mostly done by the 7th Fleet. It's headquartered at U.S. Fleet Activities Yokosuka in Yokosuka, Kanagawa Prefecture, Japan. It's part of the United States Pacific Fleet. At present, it's the largest of the forward-deployed U.S. fleets, with 60 to 70 ships, 300 aircraft, and 40,000 Navy and Marine Corps personnel. U.S. Navy warships face a credible threat from the Chinese anti-ship missiles. First is the YJ-12 and its variants. According to Chinese sources, the YJ-12 has a speed of around Mach 2 if launched from low altitude, and up to Mach 3.2 if launched from high altitude. It has a maximum range of 380 kilometers or 236 miles depending on launch altitude, so it can be fired from far off. In the terminal phase, the missile can travel at a very low altitude of 15 meters, which makes it hard for the sensors to detect. When this missile appears over the horizon and gets detected by ship sensors, the ship would only have some 45 seconds to intercept it before impact. The speed, range, and ability to skim close to the sea surface make it one of the most deadly anti-ship missiles in the world. A saturation attack by YJ-12s will be hard to defend against, even by sophisticated defenses of the U.S. military. Second is the DF-21D. DF-21D is an anti-ship ballistic missile, ASBM, and is capable of targeting a moving aircraft carrier strike group from long range. It has a maximum range exceeding 1,450 kilometers, or 900 miles, and is thought to be operational since 2009. DF-21D has hypersonic speed and can be launched from land-based launchers. It can carry a large, singular, conventional, or nuclear warhead of 600 kilograms, or around 1,320 pounds. United States Naval Institute in 2009 stated that such a warhead would be large enough to destroy an aircraft carrier in one hit, and that there was currently no defense against it if it worked as theorized. Ship defense mainly consists of active or kinetic weapons and soft or non-kinetic systems. The main active defense of U.S. warship, be it a supercarrier or destroyer or cruiser, are the Phalanx Close-In Weapon System, CIWS, RIM 116 Rolling Airframe Missile, and RIM 162A ESSM. The Phalanx CIWS is a close-in weapon system for defense against airborne threats, such as anti-ship missiles and helicopters. It was designed and manufactured by the General Dynamics Corporation, Pomona Division, which is now a part of Raytheon. It consists of a radar-guided 20mm Vulcan cannon mounted on a swiveling base. It has a max rate of fire of 4,500 rounds per minute and a range of 2.2 miles or 3.5 kilometers. The RIM 116 Rolling Airframe Missile, RAM, is a small, lightweight, infrared homing surface-to-air missile in use by the U.S. Navy. It's a point defense weapon against anti-ship cruise missiles. It has a range of 9 kilometers or 5.6 miles and a max speed of Mach 2. RAM intercepts the incoming missile. RIM 162A ESSM for anti-missile roll, with a range of 31 miles or 50 kilometers and a speed of Mach 4. It can be quad-packed in a single Mark 41 cell. Soft kill approach includes expendable decoys as well as electronic warfare system. One of the main EW systems is the ANSLQ-32. It's deployed in almost all large U.S. Navy surface combatants. The system has the ability to detect different types of battle space elements passively, and can also direct electronic warfare like jamming attacks against targets' radar and communication modules. ANSLQ-59 is designed mainly by ITT Exilis, which is now L3 Harris, and developed as part of the Surface Electronic Warfare Improvement Program, SEWIP. It is a transportable electronic warfare module, or TEWM for short. As the name suggests, the system of this kind is designed to be easily transportable. ANSLQ-59 is modular and highly adaptable, and can be reconfigured to counter newly emerging threats. It's self-contained, shock-resistant, weather-resistant enclosure, and can actually be moved from one warship to another if required. So, while ANSLQ-32 is highly integrated, ANSLQ-59 is more of a plug-and-play system that can be attached to virtually any surface combatants as per threat perception to improve its combat survivability. The capabilities of ANSLQ-59 is kept classified, but it's expected to have a significant improvement over the ANSLQ-32. One of the major enhancements is that ANSLQ-59 will have new ways to jam radars and communication components that are jam-resistant. It's very important to note that the ANSLQ-59 is deployed to the 7th Fleet warships as Urgent Operational Need, UON. So, U.S. Navy feel that 7th Fleet face a genuine threat, and it needs to respond quickly. This indicated why the South China Sea is considered to be one of the most dangerous flashpoints in the world. There's a reason for this. On December 20th of last year, a high-profile Chinese military commentator, Rear Admiral Liu Yuan, during his speech in 2018 Military Industry List Summit, told that disputes over the ownership of the East and South China Seas could be resolved by sinking two U.S. supercarriers. As reported by Taiwan's Central News Agency, he said that China's latest crop of anti-ship ballistic and cruise missiles was capable of sinking American supercarriers, and fear of casualty will frighten America. He said that the loss of one supercarrier would cost the U.S. the lives of 5,000 servicemen and women. Sinking two would double that toll. Admiral Liu added, "What the United States fears the most is taking casualties. We'll see how frightened America is." Military as well as political voices in the U.S. have pointed to Chinese provocations in the South China Sea. Republican Senator James Inhofe of Oklahoma some time back had raised serious apprehension about Chinese activities in the South China Sea during a Senate hearing earlier this year. Inhofe said, "It's like you're preparing for World War III. You're talking to our allies over there, and you wonder whose side they're going to be on." Keeping all these aspects in view, it can be easily understood that China is trying to dominate the region and is actively pursuing military options to achieve its goals. Slowly but surely, the South China Sea has become a major escalation point and one day could trigger a full-scale military conflict between two nuclear-armed nations.
Thanks for watching. Subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting, and kindly provide your feedback in the comment section. This will help us improve.